Hey, long time no see. It's been about 10 minutes. So the song that we started playing is apparently super extra copyrighted. I'm pretty sure everything I play is copyrighted, but YouTube figured it out, or someone reported me. Thanks for that. And they shut us down. So a very controversial live stream we just tried there. But we are back now. We have lost half of our viewers, so that's a bummer. So now more than ever, if you would share this link with friends who might enjoy, I would absolutely appreciate that a lot. So take two, we're now oriented correctly, so that's a good thing. I am very frustrated by all of the technical difficulties this morning, but what a perfect encapsulation of quarantine life. I think we're all pretty frustrated by everything not going according to plan for the last few weeks, and kind of the best we can do is practice acceptance. So that's what we're doing now. Gonna make the best of it, and I hope that good things come from it anyway. So once again, this is my husband, Quentin. I'm Abby Flowers, if we haven't met before, and we're just gonna play some music for you for a little while. I'm getting emails from YouTube that my video's been removed. No kidding, Chief. So we're gonna start with something else, I guess. We have been doing this for the last couple weeks, and we plan to continue doing it for several more weeks. Maybe even after quarantine ends, because this has been a fun way to connect with people in other parts of the country and maybe even other parts of the world. If you would like to tip, our Venmo username is @flower_power. Feel free to tip. We have several people who have already been so generous to us, and we are extremely grateful. But you don't thank you for your generosity. We would so appreciate if you would share this link with people outside of Nashville who might enjoy a little bit of relaxing music on a Saturday morning. So we're gonna try another song now, but as I said, pretty much everything I've ever played on my channel is copyrighted, so we could get shut down again. That may be just how edgy we are. I have to show again my bunny footy jammies. I decided to dress it up this time. So let's try another song. Thank you. I've said this before, but it's It's strange to play music for an audience that you can't hear or speak to, but we are so glad to have that privilege today. It's funny because the song, I'm not going to say the name of it, but the song that we started to play in the other live stream that got us shut down, I always feel conflicted playing it because the lyrics essentially say, ignore all of your bad feelings and just pretend that you feel great. And I obviously don't agree with that, but it's a beautiful song, so we play it anyway. So I think it's hilarious. It's a little bit of the universe looking out for us. That's not the message we needed right now. The message we needed is persevering through challenges, which is what we're doing. So, all right, we're gonna play another song that is copyrighted, but hopefully more loosely so. This is an old Elvis song that I learned performing at the Grand Hotel on Mackinac Island, Michigan, which I sure hope I have the opportunity to do again this year, but we'll see how scheduling works out. But this song is called Are You Lonesome Tonight? And I know that one of the unfortunate experiences a lot of people are having is loneliness, because we have been asked to distance ourselves for the good of ourselves and our neighbors, which is very challenging. So here's a little lonely song for you. The spectrum. I know there are certainly people who are experiencing loneliness, and I know that there are other people who are experiencing maybe a little more togetherness than they can handle, especially perhaps if you have children. You might be feeling the pressure to be on 24/7. You might have little ones following you into the bathroom. You might be praying for the day when you can have a moment alone. So on the other end of the spectrum, this is a song, it's an original song, about, I wrote it when I was dating a guy who had a roommate who just would not ever leave. She was always there, and it was annoying. So I wrote a song about it. So this song is about having more people around than maybe you bargained for. We'll repeat back to here. My shadow has grown a mind of its own. I cannot escape it at all. Reflected light, day and night, she haunts my every footfall. My shadow has grown a mind of its own and taking control of my love. There's a stone in my shoe, of coffee now. It's good to have coffee in the morning or the afternoon, depending on where you live right now. So now we're going to do a song. I have sung this song for a good while, but I recently learned a different version of it. So right before quarantine times, I was hired to play a luau-themed party, despite the fact that I do not really know any Hawaiian music. Well, now I do, but at the time, with a week of lead time, I didn't know any Hawaiian music. I didn't know what I was gonna do, but they said, could you please do this? And I said, yes, I need money, I'll do it. So, and it's because I play ukulele, of course. So I learned a lot of music and it was a beautiful experience. I've gotten to do this more over the last year of learning music that's pretty far outside of my comfort zone and discovering that I really like it. Who knew that I would like Jimmy Buffett, for example, but I enjoy it. And so prepping for the luau, I learned some, the thing is that Hawaiian music, like all types of music, is not just one thing. Hawaiian music includes a lot of different things, including really just music by Hawaiian people is part of what makes Hawaiian music. So there's a man named Israel Kamakawiwoʻole, who is very famous. So I learned a couple of his songs, and he does that iconic version of Over the Rainbow. And that's what we're going to play now. I hope that I... All right, here goes. I hope I don't need a strap for this. It's gonna be great. This is Over the Rainbow, but the version made popular by Israel Kamakawiwoʻole.
Can't I?
rainbow. I should say, so this is a concert ukulele. The other ukulele that I play is a baritone ukulele. And all of the ukuleles I play are made by Lanikai ukuleles. And the first ukulele that I ever bought was, well, that I ever owned. It was given to me as a gift. The first ukulele I ever owned was a Lanikai, but they have since sort of restarted the company with a new goal of being a ukulele that is geared toward professional musicians. Lucky me, because I needed a ukulele that was a little bit of an upgrade, and almost 2 years ago, I was very fortunate to connect with Lanikai and become one of their first sponsored artists. So they have been really wonderful to me, and I am very proud to play their instruments. So just a shout out to Lanikai. Check out their stuff if you are interested in learning ukulele. I did a series of YouTube tutorials with them a couple months ago. So you can find that on my channel and on their channel. Let's see what's next. Ooh, we're gonna do a song in Spanish. So, pardon me for a moment. If you've just joined us and you're watching live, I'm Abby Flowers. This is my husband, Quentin Flowers. I didn't marry him just for his musical abilities, but it's definitely a plus.
They're gonna say the name.
What?
Abigail Flowers.
Oh, I also married him for the name, because Flowers is my real last name. A lot of people think that it's a stage name, and I'm actually very self-conscious about that. But it's my real name. Pretty cool. Yeah, I didn't marry him just for the music. I married him for the name, too. Also, for the cooking. Let me tell you, this guy can cook, and he has been very generous, making a lot of food during quarantine, so... We've had to up our workout game to maintain equilibrium. But, all right, so we're going to play a song in Spanish. Also, I just want to say I can see that the viewer numbers are going up, and I really appreciate y'all sharing this link, especially since we had the technical difficulties. So there are several different websites where I had linked the old live stream link, and that obviously is out of date now. So I just want to say thank you so much for sharing the link and making sure, for supporting us by making this live stream available to other people. I appreciate that. So we're going to do a song in Spanish. A couple years ago, I had the distinct honor and privilege becoming the featured vocalist for a big band here in Nashville called Music City Big Band, led by Casey Brefka, who is a wonderful arranger and trumpet player. And so for a while we were doing regular swing dance nights, and playing music is fun. Playing music for dancers is amazing. Playing music for great dancers is like heaven. So I had the opportunity to sing with this big band for great dancers. We would do swing dance nights at Woolworth on Fifth. Anyways, one of the songs that I learned specifically for that group is What a Difference a Day Made. And we had a specific arrangement of it. And so I was trying to learn the song or chart the song by ear so I could play it for myself. And as I was researching the song, because when I try to determine the chords, especially for jazz standards, there are a lot of different versions out there. So you could listen to one person and they're playing these chords. You listen to a different person, they're playing the different chords. So one strategy that I employ is see when the song was written or published or first recorded, and then find the earliest recordings you can. And that's gonna give you, hopefully, the most accurate picture of what the real chords are. Of course, you can break the rules, but it's good to know the rules before you break them. So, I love to talk, I'm sorry. So, in researching this song, to my surprise, I found out it was originally done in Spanish, and it's written by a Mexican woman named Maria Grever, and the song is called Cuando Vuelva a tu Lado, When I Return to Your Side. And I think that is very cool. I love singing in Spanish. And yeah, so we'll do it in Spanish and English, and we'll swing it for the English. Sing. Thank you guys for tuning in, being here with us. Okay, so I'm gonna play an original. We have two more songs for you. This next one is an original, and it has been on my mind. I wrote it 2 years ago, and it feels uncomfortably relevant, although this is certainly not what I had in mind when I wrote it. It's called Spring Never Felt So Wrong, and the original idea behind the song was inspired by a loss experienced by family friends, and so it's about when you experience a loss and your world kind of freezes. And it feels wrong to see the world around you continuing and moving on. But it's been on my mind, because this is just a really weird time, and it's officially spring, and a lot of things that we thought we would be doing right now, we're not able to do. Even if you are materially provided for, there is a lot of loss on all different scales. I just got a funny text, sorry. There's a lot of loss. There's a lot of emotions happening. And so, daily reminder that even if you are really fortunate and you have everything that you need right now, it's okay to be grieving. It's okay to feel sad because we are all experiencing loss of some kind. Anyway, this is Spring Never Felt So Wrong. And we'll just do straight down notes. My mom encouraged me to play that the other day. I was doing an Instagram live stream with Lanakai, and she said, play Spring. And I said, but that's a really sad song. And she said, yeah, that's okay. So thanks, Mama. All right, we are going to do one more song for you. Again, thank you so much for joining us this morning, despite the technical difficulties. Once again, if you would like to tip, please do not feel pressured to tip, especially if you have been tipping the last couple of weeks. We so appreciate your generosity. If you would like to tip, our Venmo username is @flower_power, flower power. And if you're not in a position to tip, we would so appreciate it if you would just share this link with other people. We're going to be doing this every Saturday morning for the foreseeable future at 11 a.m. Central. So I'll try to update the links and make sure that it's easy enough to find. But currently, I have like the next month of live stream links up on my website, which is abigailflowersmusic.com. And if you click on the shows link, it'll give you a list of our live streams and an easy to click on link for each of those. So that's an easy way to share. So this last song I picked I'll try to be brief, but you know me, it's not gonna happen. I love old music, and most of the music that I connect to was made by people who are not alive anymore. And there are a few exceptions to that. I can appreciate all kinds of music, but as far as what really moves me, there are pretty much like three artists that I really connect to. And one of them is Emily King. I saw Emily King perform on Easter a few years ago at City Winery, and it was just her and her producer/guitarist. And just cried the whole time. It was beautiful. And then last year on my birthday, I got to see her at 3rd and Lindsley with a full band, background dancers. It was incredible. And even in that like way more produced setting, cried the whole time. I just love her. So I think part of why I like her is both of her parents are very traditional jazz vocalists, wonderful artists of their own. So I'm guessing that her jazz influences have a lot to do with what makes me connect with her. Anyway, so Emily King is currently quarantined with her mother in New York, and they have been doing videos together. And they did a duet video of this song, Dream, parentheses, When You're Feeling Blue, and Aren't We All? And it was so beautiful, and it's one of my favorite songs. I learned this also on Mackinac a few years ago from Peter Mielich, who is one of my musical mentors and just one of the best pianists out there in general. So I love this song. They did a video with two-part harmony, and it was just begging for a third part. So I did a little video singing along with it, and I had fun doing it. Right before we went live with this, Emily King herself liked and commented some little heart emojis on my video, so that really was a nice surprise for today. I was gonna play this song anyway, but now I can play it with a little bit of a fuller heart. So we're gonna do Dream When You're Feeling Blue. Here goes. Last four. For tuning in. We'll be here next Saturday morning at 11 a.m. Central. I don't know how I can top the bunny rabbit footy jammies, but I'll do my darndest. I hope you guys have a good week. I think that's it. Thank you.